In this lesson, I will show you how to create a simple sketch in Fusion 360 and you will learn some tools for creating geometry and some constraints. To create a sketch, select the Create Sketch command. Then you need to specify the plane on which you will create this sketch. And we have the basic planes of the coordinate systems available. XY, XZ, and YZ planes. And which plane is which, these axes indicate. And in 3D CAD systems, the x-axis is marked red. Y-axis is green, z-axis is blue. And this is a reference to the RGB system, that is red, green, blue. And the reference to this color system will make it easier to remember which color corresponds to which axis. But here, in the upper right corner, these axes are also marked. And the red axis is the x-axis, the blue axis is the z-axis. And when we turn it, the y-axis is marked green. In the next lesson, I will talk about basic things related to navigation. And now let's jump to the sketch plane and select the XY plane. And to select the sketch plane, just click the left mouse button on this plane. And at this point, we switch to the sketch tab, where we have the sketch tools. And here we have the basic geometries that we can use to create a sketch. And in this lesson, we will use a few basic geometries. And at the beginning, I would like to create a rectangle in such a way that the center of the rectangle lies at the beginning of the coordinate system. Let's choose from the Create menu the rectangle and center rectangle. And this command allows you to create a rectangle in such a way that we indicate the center of the rectangle. Click the left mouse button at the beginning of the coordinate system and then indicate the second point of the rectangle. Click anywhere, more or less here, and we have a rectangle. But the rectangle drawing command is still active and we can create more rectangles. To cancel the rectangle drawing command and generally to cancel the command, press the escape key. Here, this rectangle in this drawing is not necessary, so click undo. And we have a rectangle, but this rectangle is not dimensioned yet. The position of the center point of this rectangle is already defined. And the center point of the rectangle is connected to the beginning of the coordinate system, but the rectangle is not dimensioned yet. And by holding the left mouse button on the corner of the rectangle or on some side of the rectangle, we can change the dimensions of this rectangle. To determine the dimensions of the rectangle, use the sketch dimension command, just make sure that no geometry is selected. In such situations, before I choose the dimension or before I choose a constraint, I click the left mouse button somewhere outside the geometry to make sure that all the geometries are deselected. And now choose sketch dimension and indicate this side of the rectangle and here enter 100 mm. And now the length of this side is 100 mm. The sketch dimension command is still active, so let's dimension the next geometry. Click on this line. Click with the left mouse button somewhere on the side to determine the position of the dimension and here enter 80 mm. Press escape to cancel the dimension and the rectangle is already dimensioned and the geometry of the rectangle has changed color to black. And this means that this sketch is fully defined. It is already fully dimensioned and its position is also fully defined and we cannot freely change the position of this rectangle or the dimensions of this rectangle. Now, when I grab the corner of the rectangle or the side of the rectangle, I can no longer change the dimensions of the rectangle. And okay, we have a rectangle and now I would like to create two circles in such a way that they lie on the line passing through the center of the rectangle. That is, on the line that will overlap with the x-axis and be placed symmetrically about the y-axis. And for this purpose, I need construction geometry and I will create two construction geometries, choose line drawing. And to create a line that will pass through the center of the rectangle, we can use automatic constraints and now when you hover over the center of the rectangle, a triangle icon will appear and when you click here, the first point of this line will be connected to the center of the side of the rectangle. And now hover over to the other side, a triangle also appears. Click with the left mouse button and a line has been created that passes through the center of the rectangle. And this symbol defines the center point, but we will draw the second line in a different way. I will draw any line. Press Escape to cancel the line drawing command, and now I will use Symmetry Constraint to place this line in the middle of this rectangle. Choose Symmetry Constraint, select this line and this line, then select this line, and now this line has been placed in the middle of the rectangle. Press Escape to cancel the symmetry constraint, and at this point these lines are ordinary sketch lines, and could take part in the further stage of creating a 3D solid based on a 2D sketch, but we don't need it at this point, so select these two lines with the Control key and select this icon to define that these lines are construction lines. That is, such auxiliary lines in the sketch. Click outside the geometry to deselect all the geometries and now select drawing a circle and let's create a circle somewhere outside the geometry. Okay. Press Escape to cancel the drawing of the circle, select the sketch dimension command. Indicate the circle and here enter 10 mm as the diameter of this circle. Press Escape and I would like the center of this circle to lie on this line and for this purpose select the coincidence constraint, select the center of the circle. Select this line and the center of this circle is already on this line. Press Escape to cancel this command. And now by holding the left mouse button you can move this circle only along this line. And now I would like to create a second circle that will lie on the other side of the y-axis and we could do it manually. We could just draw a second circle, but we can also select this circle, then choose the mirror command from the create menu. Here, as an object, we already have one object, one geometry selected, then click this button to activate the selection of the mirror line. Select this line and click OK and in this way the second circle has been created, which lies on the other side of the y-axis. And now when I change the position of this circle, the position of this circle also changes. And now these circles lie on this line and are placed symmetrically relative to the y-axis, but let's add a specific dimension between these circles here. Click the left mouse button outside the geometry to deselect the selected geometry. Select sketch dimension, select the center of this circle, select the center of this circle and here as a dimension enter 75 mm and press enter. And okay. The whole sketch is already black, so the whole sketch is already fully defined and that's where we'll finish this lesson. Click Finish Sketch to exit the sketch and in the next lesson, based on this sketch, we will create a 3D solid.